راجیہ سبھا ٹی وی کا یہ بے حد خاص پروگرام ہے گفتگو، اور گفتگو کا آج کا یہ ایپیسوڈ اس لیے بے حد خاص اور یادگار ہونے جا رہا ہے کیونکہ ہمارے ساتھ ہیں آج ویوورد اینیمیشن آرٹسٹ رام موہن، جو کہ بھارت میں اینیمیشن کلا کے جنک لوگوں میں سے ایک گنے جاتے ہیں۔ मोहन भारत में एनिमेशन कला के पितामह राम मोहन आज सन 2016 में 85 साल के हैं। दो दो बार राष्ट्रीय फिल्म पुरस्कार से सम्मानित राम मोहन भारत सरकार द्वारा पद्मश्री से भी नवाजे जा चुके हैं। उनके रचे एनिमेशन प्रोग्राम्स आज मील का पत्थर माने जाते हैं। केरल में जन्मे और मंगलुरु में पले बढ़े राम मोहन यूं तो विज्ञान के छात्र रहे हैं, लेकिन कला के प्रति रुझान ने उन्हें एनिमेटर बना दिया। फिल्म डिवीजन के साथ एनिमेशन कला में पारंगत हुए वेटरन एनिमेटर राम मोहन का करियर काफी साहसिक प्रयोगों से भरा है। किसी भी एक जगह पर जमकर न रहने वाले राम मोहन ने हर पल नए अवसर ढूंढे और अपनी रचनात्मकता से ऑडियो विजुअल जगत को नए अनुभवों से अवगत कराया। मुंबई के फिल्म डिवीजन में वॉल्ट डिज्नी स्टूडियो के क्लेयर वीक से एनिमेशन की ट्रेनिंग पाने के बाद राम मोहन ने स्टोरी इलस्ट्रेटर, लेआउट आर्टिस्ट, ट्रेनी एनिमेटर, सीनियर एनिमेटर और स्टोरी बोर्ड आर्टिस्ट के तौर पर काम किया। 1956 में फिल्म डिवीजन के साथ शुरू हुआ राम मोहन का सफर करीब 10 साल चला। इसके बाद राम मोहन ने खुद का काम शुरू कर दिया।
जननी मैं राम दूत हनुमान, जननी मैं राम दूत हनुमान।
उन्होंने दक्षिण भारत की मशहूर फिल्म कंपनी प्रसाद प्रोडक्शंस के एनिमेशन डिवीजन को संभाला, अपनी प्रोडक्शन कंपनी राम मोहन बायोग्राफिक्स का संचालन किया, ग्राफिटी मल्टीमीडिया के बैनर तले एनिमेशन एक्टिविटीज करते रहे और अभी हाल हाल तक यू टीवी टून्स के जरिए नए नए एनिमेटर्स तैयार करते रहे।
देखो मीना, मेरा भाई उस कटे हुए पेड़ के ठूंठ को उठाने के लिए लीवर का इस्तेमाल कर रहा है। ये छड़ पहले तने के ऊपर जाती है, फिर पेड़ के ठूंठ के नीचे, फिर वह दूसरे सिरे को दबाता है। देखा, इसे कहते हैं लीवर।
आओ मीना, मेरी मदद करो।
राम मोहन के बनाए कई एनिमेशन टाइटल सीक्वेंस जिन फिल्मों में देखे जा सकते हैं, उनमें 2 और 2 5,
चींटियां एक एक कण चुटाकर अपनी बिलों तक ले जाती,
काम चोर,
मुश्किल थी ना हल,
पति पत्नी और वो, हसीना मान जाएगी, बीवी ओ बीवी,
अंग्रेज सरकार को जब किसी नवाब से कोई शिकायत होती तो,
और शतरंज के खिलाड़ी प्रमुख हैं। बहुत बहुत स्वागत है राम मोहन जी। हमको बताइए कि ये जो एनिमेशन की कला में आप पहुंचे, कहां से चलकर एनिमेशन आर्टिस्ट आप बने?
कहाँ से चले थे और क्या क्या जर्नी क्या है ये?
मेरा जन्म केरला में हुई एंड देन आई केम टू मैंगलोर जहाँ मेरा एजुकेशन कंप्लीट हुआ. आई बिकेम ए साइंस ग्रेजुएट एंड देन फॉर फर्दर स्टडीज आई केम टू बॉम्बे. माई attention was diverted from science to arts when I came across Mr. Claire Weeks. वो थे एक senior animator from Walt Disney Studio जो बॉम्बे में आए थे to start a training program. And I was one of the trainees he accepted because though I was not by training, I am not an artist. I had never been taught how to draw or paint, but I had been interested in cartooning. My cartoon karte rehta tha for magazines and for newspapers, and because it was my interest in comics and art and comic arts and cartooning, I met Claire Weeks, who had come from Walt Disney Studio to set up a training program, and it was in the cartoon film unit of films division. It had just been initiated sometime in 1955 or so. And in 1956, I joined the unit and I was one of the trainees. And that is how I got into animation, though it was not something that I actually planned to do.
आपने कहा राम मोहन जी कि आप मैंगलोर से मुंबई आए, क्यों आए थे मुंबई?
Yes, in Mangalore I was studying at a Saint Aloysius College and I did science as most young people were encouraged to do. Either it was science or commerce for boys and art and other subjects for girls. But my interest was not so much in science. It was more towards drawing and sketching and cartooning. But since there was no such thing as a profession, one had to go for either science or commerce. Now, after finishing my BSc in Mangalore, I came to Bombay with the intention of continuing to do my MSc. But at that point, I came to know about a program that was being introduced by films division.
How you came to know about that?
Well, it was actually in an evening mag newspaper called the Evening News, which Times of India used to publish. And there was a small article about a gentleman called Claire Weeks. He had come from Walt Disney Studio. He was a senior animator and he was supposed to conduct an animation course, a training program, which would be about 2 years, I suppose. So I was very interested in meeting Mr. Weeks because I was always interested in cartooning, but also in animation films, which we rarely got to see around in those years. But whenever there was an opportunity, I used to go and see Disney films, and I was very eager to go and meet Mr. Weeks. And I got an opportunity to meet him in films division, and he saw my work. I had done some cartoons for magazines like the Illustrated Weekly of India and so on. And he asked me whether I would like to join films division as a trainee. And I was very happy to be accepted there for the program. And that is how I got my initial training in animation.
And how many trainees were there in under Claire Weeks?
When we initially joined films division, there were hardly about 10 to 12 people who had been accepted for the program. And later on, I think it gradually expanded to about 25 or 30 people. Gradually, some more people were taken up, and it sort of remained at that level. It never grew into one of those large commercial studios which would have hundreds of artists. It was not like that. But we were given training by Claire Weeks himself for about 2 years. And we made one film called The Ban in India. It was a Jataka story. And he had given us some initial inspirational drawings, which were more based more on Disney's Bambi and so on. Mm-hmm. But that was our training program.
Kitni lambi, kitni film, kitne duration ki film thi wo?
It was about, I think, 15 to 17 minutes long. Mm-hmm. And it took us nearly 2 years to do it because it was a slow process of learning. And, but it was a good subject to take up at that time because it was entirely the story of a deer which sacrifices its life for its herd and its other characters in the story. So the program was not a very intense program, but there was enough reference material for us to learn from, and Mr. Weeks was there to guide us. And the picture turned out to be fairly good. I wouldn't say it was a great or excellent production, but it was, for an initial exercise, it turned out to be quite an interesting film.
वो अगर आप याद कीजिए कि वो कौन सा साल कौन सा रहा होगा कौन से ईयर में ये सब बात हो रही थी
जॉय फिल्म्स डिवीजन फॉर दिस ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम इन 1956 दिसंबर दैट इज एंड ऑफ द ईयर एंड देन मिस्टर वीक्स वाज हियर विद अस अप टू 1959 और सो एंड इट वाज ड्यूरिंग दिस टू इयर्स दैट ही वाज हियर
लेकिन ये आप देखेंगे कि इसमें हम लोगों के पास उससे पहले बहुत ज़्यादा एनिमेशन का काम तो था नहीं और वो भी एक आप भी खुद सीख रहे थे और मिस्टर क्लेयर वीक्स आपको सिखा रहे थे जो कि खुद इंडियन जो कम्युनिकेशन नीड्स हैं और बिहेवियर है ह्यूमन बिहेवियर और उसका कम्युनिकेशन का जो पैटर्न है उसको तो बहुत ज़्यादा उस इथॉस को नहीं समझ पाते होंगे वो क्योंकि वो खुद वॉल्ट डिज़्नी स्टूडियो से आए थे कैसे इस ट्रेनिंग को एक इंडियनाइज कंडीशंस
में वेल वन रीजन व्हाई मिस्टर वीक्स वाज सिलेक्टेड बाय द यूएस गवर्नमेंट फॉर द ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम एज अ टीचर वाज बिकॉज मिस्टर वीक्स वाज इन इंडिया एट इन हिज ओन चाइल्डहुड ही वाज ब्रॉट अप हियर समटाइम इन द नॉर्थ आई थिंक मसूरी और सम प्लेस एंड His parents knew some Hindi and as a child, Mr. Weeks himself was familiar with the language. He knew a little Hindi, so he could communicate. And apart from that, we could communicate through drawings. That was the main thing because he had brought in a lot of sketches, drawings, paintings, background paintings. And they were available to us to refer to and our training was essentially in a system that Disney had developed. So it was in that own sort of semi-realistic drawings that we did in those days. That was what we were trained in and it was not very difficult to communicate and understand what he was teaching.
तो ये film division के साथ आपका association उसके बाद चलता रहा. कितना लंबा एसोसिएशन आपका रहा
सी आफ्टर वीक्स लेफ्ट फॉर सम टाइम देयर वाज मस्ट बी मिस्टर सराया जी ए सराया वाज सॉर्ट ऑफ अ डायरेक्टर इन द यूनिट बट ही आल्सो लेफ्ट आफ्टर सम टाइम बिकॉज ही वाज मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन मेकिंग इंडियन फीचर फिल्म हिंदी फीचर फिल्म ही मेड अ फिल्म कॉल्ड सरस्वती चंद्रा एंड एट दैट टाइम ही लेफ्ट After some time, he left Films Division, and Mr. Weeks was replaced by, or not Mr. Weeks was not replaced. There was a producer. As a producer, we got Mr. Pati, Pramod Pati. Now, Pramod Pati was from, I think, he was initially employed in the Orissa government, but he came to India after having trained or we are having spent a couple of years in Czechoslovakia, in Prague, with Jerry Trinka and others. So he took over after weeks, and he became the inspiration for the cartoon film unit, because what we were used to under Mr. Weeks was essentially the Disney way of production, the Disney way of design. It was an established style, and we were always being guided to imitate that style. But when Pramod Pathy came and he took over as an officer in charge, he brought in a new approach, something that was, to me and to people who were at that time working in cartoon unit, it was something very different, something new. And it was inspired more by the East European style of animation, which was more stylized. The drawings were more stylized. The animation, the movements also matched the stylization of the design and so on. And so he introduced a new way of illustration and of designing the films. And that was the sort of second phase for animation for us in the training program.
So, you didn't tell us how long you were in the films division.
After that, I stayed on. Even after Mr. Pramod Pathy was promoted and became a deputy. Deputy director, not the director, he was deputy producer, chief producer. So he became the deputy chief producer, but he was still in films division. And that was a very lively period when a lot of new types of documentaries were being made in the films division and so on. Mr. Jan Bhavnagri was also, I think, delegated. He came as an advisor. He was there for some time. And under his guidance and under his encouragement, a new type of films were made, even in live documentaries, but also in the animation program itself, there were some very innovative styles that were introduced.
So, films division, mein rehte hue, aapne kaun si aisi filmein kuch yaad aati hon jo aapne banayi?
Well, in films division, I was essentially an assistant animator, and I used to work with the group, and there were a couple of people who were senior to me, and though I designed, my main contribution to whatever films they were made at that time were essentially as an illustrator, as a character designer and a storyboard artist. I used to prepare storyboards. I also wrote a few scripts for some films that were being made there. And one was, I think, Shadow and Substance was one of the films that I contributed to at that time. And it is now such a long time since I made those films. But essentially, we were following a style that was given to us, or we got into because of Mr. Weeks being there. And after Mr. Weeks left and Pramod Pathy took over as officer in charge, there was more emphasis on design and a variety of ways of illustrations and so on. And those were the times when I think I learned a lot. My education in animation continued during those days when Pramod Pathy was there. The remarkable thing about Mr. Pramod Pathy was that he was somebody who wanted to involve all the artists in the studio. Even when he was evolving a story, when it was being developed, he invited us to come and participate in the production process right from the beginning, even in writing the story or in contributing to the character design and so on. So I was encouraged a lot more to learn more about the creative aspect of animation filmmaking, not merely as a technician to make the drawings, but beyond that, actually in the process of filmmaking. And in 1967, there was an international event. It was called the Expo 67 in Montreal, in Canada. And I was very eager to learn more about what was happening in the rest of the world in the field of animation. So I myself, on my own, with my own whatever money I had saved at that time, decided to take a trip to Montreal and visit the event. That was it was a sort of an international coming together of animators from various countries, and it was an opportunity for me to go and meet these people from East Europe as well as from USA. And during that period, while I was there, I also got an opportunity to meet McLaren, Norman McLaren, who was in charge of the animation studio in the National Film Board of Canada. So I spent a couple of weeks in his studio, and even in this very short period that I was there, I learned such a lot about new innovations, new styles, new techniques that were being developed by Norman McLaren himself. And he was a very open, very friendly person, and I had gained a lot of knowledge about the new developments in animation at that time. And when I came back from Montreal and came back to Films Division, I was a little unhappy about my own career in Films Division, because I thought I was being just a cog in the wheel. I was just being part of a studio that was more interested in doing propaganda films. That is, it was part of the planned publicity program at that time. 5-year plans had been launched, and the most of the films that we were doing were supposed to promote the 5-year plans that were being promoted at that time. And we made many films essentially for that kind of programs, like there was something about small savings, small families, about making compost pits, about making fisheries in villages, and things like that. We tried to make them more interesting by using the animation technique itself and introducing some humor in the storytelling and so on. But essentially, it was all about propaganda for the 5-year plans that were being promoted at that time. So after spending some time with the National Film Board of Canada, after I came back, I was feeling a little restless, and I thought I should be doing something more than that, or something different from what I have been doing. And that was when I got an offer from the
Prasad.
With the Prasad Productions of Madras. Now, Prasad Productions had already imported some state-of-the-art equipment, like the optical bench for doing opticals, and also the rostrum camera. Both of them were from Hawkesbury, which was considered to be one of the best equipment one could use for animation at that time. And they offered me the job of running their special effects and animation department, but they had set it up in Chennai. At that time it was Madras. So they asked me whether I would like to come and work with them in Madras. Now, I had already settled down in Bombay at that time, and I told them that I would not be able to shift to Madras. It was difficult for me. But if they brought the equipment to Bombay, I'd be very happy to work with them and help them make films. I thought there was more opportunity for me to do it, even as a independent filmmaker. I would be better off doing commercials, advertising films, and even independent documentaries on my own, rather than just continue in film division. And so I said that if they would bring their equipment here, I would be willing to work with them. And they agreed. Then they came to Tardev in Bombay, in Film Center, which happens to be a processing lab, film processing laboratory, where they found some space for making their animation department. So since I had promised them that I would join them if they brought it, and they did bring the equipment, so I left Film Division and joined. I came into the private sector anyway, but immediately after that I was made an offer for promotion in Film Division itself. But I said, I'm sorry, I had already made up my mind to step out of the public sector into the private sector. And so for the next 4 years I was with Prasad Productions, and we made some very interesting films at that time, and I got to make films the way I wanted to make them.
Kuch naam lijiye.
One of the first film that I made was called Baap Re Baap. It was about family planning again, but I made it visually more interesting by creating multiple screens within the normal format of the screen. So it had two families. It was a story about two families, one with just two children, a boy and a girl, and there's another family with four children, double the number of children. And it was a straight comparison between what happens in the two families, it was planned in such a way that there were two screens within the normal screen, where the same incident or a similar incident in the two families would happen. For example, if they had, each family has a cow from which they get milk. Now, the two farmers who are there, the fathers, they milk their cows and they bring the milk home. But when it is distributed, the smaller family is able to give more milk, and a cup of milk for the boy and for the girl, and there is enough milk for the father and the mother also. But in the larger family, the same amount of milk will have to be distributed among so many people. So naturally there is less for each of them. And similarly in the space, when it's time to sleep, the children come and spread their beds and sleep. And the father is pushed each time to closer and closer to the door, and finally he finds himself out in the rain because there is not enough space for everybody inside the house, and so on. So this was a film that had multiple screens, for one thing. That was something that I found useful in telling the story. And I told the story without using any dialogue or voiceover narrative or anything like that. It was entirely music, and that got the award that year for the best this family planning film of the year. That was in 1969, yeah. That was the first time. And after that, I made a film called You Said It. That I made for Films Division itself. As an independent producer outside Films Division, I made a film for them. This was about a common man and what is his role in the structure, that is the government structure, how he gets a voice by participating in a election, and how his voice is heard by through the representative in a panchayat or in a state government or in a central government, how he participates, he becomes a participant in the governance of the country.
So by that time, R.K. Lakshman's common man was there.
These,
because the name of the strip was also You Said It.
Yeah, that was used by Films Division. In fact, a suggestion came from them that because the central character was the common man, they said we would use that name, which was popular. But actually, the design and the storytelling was entirely different. It was very stylized. The character was different. I made my own common man, but the film turned out to be good enough to get another national award for me. And that was in 1972. And after that, I made a series of films on population and environment called Down to Earth, which was sponsored by the International Planned Parenthood Federation. And that became extremely useful in the population education. It was shown in many schools, in many languages, and it's sort of a landmark for me. I mean, it was one of those things that was really interested in promoting environmental, how we should take care of the environment and how we should, and it was also advocated population control to some extent.
And then you worked for Prasad for how many years?
Now, Prasad's, I told them that I would, even when I joined them, I said I would work with them for about 4 years and then I would become independent. And so in 72, I started my own company called Ram Mohan Biographics.
Ram Mohan?
Biographics, meaning living graphics. And that company, I was there using their space and equipment for quite some time, right up to 1985. And later, in 1996, 1997, that is when I closed down my own unit, because we had reached a point where we were not able to expand any further. We had a studio in Mahim, and we had about 30 people, but that was not enough, because at that time, suddenly the animation industry had begun to grow, and the initial, what many people were thinking of at that time was to use animation as a service, about how to work for outsourced work. I mean, there were producers abroad who were willing to send work to India and get it done here. But we had to train a lot of new people because the volume of work was a lot more than what we could handle. So it was a partnership with Ronnie Screwvala, who is a businessman in Bombay.
UTV.
So UTV and I, we put our heads together and we thought we would start this, it was initially called RMUSL, and later on it became UTV Tunes, and essentially it grew because of the the interest there was also among the young people to learn animation. People, there was hardly any animation programs, studio teaching programs. There were no more. After Mr. Weeks left, we did not have any training programs, and there were no institutions teaching animation. So we started, apart from the studio itself, where we did the animation for work that came from Canada mainly and US, we also started a program where we would take about 30 people every 6 months, train them for about 6 months, and then put them on the job in UTV. And as they worked on new projects, they learned. So the learning and earning went on together for those boys. And by the end of the next 4 years, we had trained almost 300 to 350 people. It was growing at that rate. And we had about, and some of them turned out to be really good, because we took mostly people who had already been trained in art schools or colleges, mainly our JJ School of Art or Raheja School of Art. And while they worked with the senior animators, they also learned. So the animation industry began to grow steadily larger. And by the time I had a contract with them for 5 years, and by the time I left 2004, they already had about 400 to 450 animators working there.
Ram Mohan ji, aapko ye lagta hai ki jo animation ki kala thi us par bahut zyada dhyan diya nahi gaya, uske liye jo infrastructure aur jo funds जो भी चीज़ें होनी चाहिए वो नहीं किया गया हम लोगों के यहाँ कंट्री में हमारी?
वेल यस, एनिमेशन वॉज नेवर टेकन वेरी सीरियसली. आई थिंक मोस्ट पीपल रिफर टू इट एज कार्टून फिल्म्स, एंड इमीडिएटली वन वुड स्टार्ट थिंकिंग ऑफ फनी कार्टून्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन. सो दे सेड इट्स ऑल जस्ट फॉर चिल्ड्रन, एंड इट नेवर बिकेम पार्ट ऑफ द मेन स्ट्रीम ऑफ फिल्म मेकिंग. So though we were mostly in Bombay, we never became really a part of the major feature film industry. Occasionally, when we were in, when I was with Prasad Productions, occasionally some producers would come, the Hindi film producers, and ask us to make animated titles for feature films, which we did. And some of them are still remembered by people, like there was Do or Do Paanch, and then there was Haseena Maan Jayegi, and then later on for Raj Kapoor's their studio made BVOBV, and then even some very senior and well-known directors like Satyajit Ray and Mrinal Sen, they wanted short animation inserts in their feature film. Like for Shatranj Ki Khiladi, for Satyajit Ray, we made, there was an introductory sort of a piece in the film where the voiceover provided by Amitabh Bachchan, he speaks about what the historical background was to this story. The Shatranj Ki Khiladi, and we did that piece about Wajid Ali Shah and the British, how they came and took away parts of his Awadh and so on. So this was done in a stylized way, and it was animated for the film. And Mr. Ray had personally come and discuss the whole thing with me, and we did a small piece of animation that was liked by him very much. It was one of the few small pieces of animation that I remember as part of the of a feature film. And there was also, and similarly, an introductory piece that we did for Mrinal Sen when he made Bhuvan Shom. So these were some interesting pieces of work that we did. But other than that, most of the work I did during those about 25 years as Ram Mohan biographics, mostly it was advertising films, commercials. Initially, it was mainly for the cinema. There were longer films, about 1 minute long ad films that we used to work. And so it took more time than making feature films or with live characters.
उसमें अगर देखें कि राम मोहन बायोग्राफिक्स के बैनर में कभी कोई बड़ी फुल लेंथ फीचर फिल्म बनाने का कभी कोई ऐसा
द ओनली अपॉर्चुनिटी दैट आई मेड हैड ऑफ मेकिंग अ फीचर लेंथ फिल्म वाज व्हेन अ जापानीज प्रोड्यूसर कॉल्ड युगो साको ही केम टू इंडिया ही वाज मेकिंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट्री ऑन द रिवर गंगा एंड व्हाइल मेकिंग द फिल्म ही हैड हर्ड अबाउट रामायण. He was intrigued by how much was it was an influence in the lives of the people who lived there along the Ganga. And he went and read the original Ramayana in Japanese, and he felt that was a very good subject for animation. Mm-hmm. So he came back to India in search of collaborators, and somebody told him to meet me, and so we together worked on the project. Initially, the idea was to make it an Indo-Japanese co-production, but at that time there was some hesitation about making this subject. The Ramayana itself, the Ayodhya was itself becoming a sort of a political problem at that time, and so the ministry was not very enthusiastic about making the art animation for a film about Ramayana. They thought. Animation again. They thought animation would mean cartoon.
Cartoon.
Cartoon would be not the right kind
form.
Of format for
mythology and
for mythology. So they did not encourage us very much. But finally, the Japanese producer said that he would raise the money in Japan itself. It would be the production would be done in Japan. And I was supposed to collaborate as a co-producer, as a co-director. I worked with him, and we got the entire script. Script was developed here. All the character designs were done by me, and we did also part of the storyboarding, and. The music was done here. The playground music by Vantaraj Bhatia was recorded here. The songs were recorded here. So a great deal of pre-production was done here. And the film was completed between 1990 and 1992. And initially, because it was considered as a Japanese production, it was not given much publicity. In fact, people had hardly seen the film on the big screen. But around 2000 or so, Cartoon Network, it found it was very suitable for children on television. So they bought the rights both for English and the Hindi versions, and they were shown on TV. Particularly between Dasara and Diwali, they used to have Ramayana on TV, the animated Ramayana, and that turned out to be quite popular.
अगर आप देखें तो जिस तरह का ये एक preconceived notion है कि animation का मतलब cartoon, तो क्या इस attitude ने हमारे अपने यहाँ इस art को develop होने में बहुत
problem? Yeah, I think it was sort of an obstacle because of this misunderstanding, which still continues a great deal, that it is meant for children, it's very frivolous, and it is not to be taken seriously. So, if you see films being made abroad now, the animation medium is being used for subjects which are very, very subtle and very thought-provoking. In the sense, it's not just for the amusement of children. In fact, there was a film recently released last year called Inside Out, which explored the mind of a child and what happens within the mind, child's mind. And it was more about the psychology of the child and its emotions. And things like these can be handled in a medium like animation, because in terms of design and the illustrations of what happens within the child's mind, these were challenging, but it can be done in animation. It will be very difficult to do that in live action.
आपके दौर में जब तक आपने काम किया और जो मेथडोलॉजी और जो टेक्निक और जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर आपने इस्तेमाल किया और जो आज हो रहा है, जो आज हो रहा है उसके बारे में कुछ आपको?
या इनफैक्ट द कंप्यूटर एज अ मीडियम एंड डिजिटल टूल्स एज अ मीडियम केम अराउंड द 80s इन इंडिया. इट स्टार्टेड अर्लियर अब्रॉड, बट इन इंडिया some small studios were trying to use computers and computer generated animation. And one of the projects I got involved in was by with 4 or 5 people. Among them was some senior members of the advertising world, like Prahlad Kakkar, and there was a IIT graduate called Ashish Khosla. And now we set up a small unit called Graffiti. And of course, the idea was still to use the medium of computer animation, computer-generated animation, mostly for commercials. And since advertising, the advertising fraternity always looks for something different, something new to attract the attention of the audience. And since television was becoming more and more popular as a medium for advertising, so we started out very well. And later on, Graffiti has developed more of using computer as a medium for generating animation. And today, more and more the world over, this has become the medium of choice, the 3D effects, and also the special effects using a lot of animation and also other computer generated effects. These have become very common for animation now.
ज़्यादातर लोग जब भी कोई टेक्नोलॉजी बदलती है या कोई नए स्टेज में कोई चीज़ पहुंचती है तो उसकी बुराई करने लगते हैं कि ऐसा हो गया तो इसने, और वो अपने बार बार अपने दौर में जाकर अपने ही किए हुए काम को ग्लोरीफाई करते रहते हैं और एक तरह का नॉस्टैल्जिया जीते रहते हैं. आपका क्या एक्सपीरियंस है कि जिस एनवायरनमेंट में आपने काम किया और जो डिजिटल एनवायरनमेंट आज है, कौन सा आपको लगता है कि अच्छा था?
वेल एक्चुअली आई स्टार्टेड एज अ 2D एनिमेटर यूजिंग द ओल्ड टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ हैंड ड्रॉन एनिमेशन, एंड आई थिंक दैट वाज एप्रोप्रिएट फॉर आवर कल्चर, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द आर्ट वर्क वी सी इन आवर फोक आर्ट, इट्स ऑल हैंड ड्रॉन. एंड the kind of designs, hand-drawn designs, the folk designs, were appropriate for the 2D medium. But I think if for the economy of production, I think the use of computers has become more popular, more because of the economy of it. But we, for example, made a series of films based on the life of a little child, a girl child. In fact, the subject was girl child in South Asia and how they are treated in a normal Indian family. And so there was a series of short films that we made. The series was called Meena. It was a girl about 8 or 9 years old. She was 8 or 9 years old. And there were situations within the family where, for example, education. The boy is sent to the school, the little boy, who is the little brother, he goes to school because they know that the boy needs education, but they think the girl doesn't have to go to school. The usual attitude that she has to grow up and do housework, so why go to school? So there was a story about how she finally convinces her parents that she must also go to school. And then there is nutrition. When something nutritious is cooked in the family, more of it is given to the boy, and what is left over a little is given to the girl. And then how they exchange their roles, and how the girl, the boy realizes how much the girl has to do and how much she works for the family, and how she also needs nutrition as much as the boy does. And similarly, many situations where we just show what is the present condition of a girl and how much she needs care and education and all the advantages as the boy has, and that becomes and that has become a very popular series, particularly in Bangladesh, where the original story was the first.
आखिर में आपसे पूछेंगे, आखिर में आपसे पूछेंगे राम मोहन जी के जो कुछ जो जिंदगी आपकी एनिमेशन आर्ट के भीतर गुजरी, उसमें क्या-क्या अचीवमेंट्स हैं जिनको लेकर आपका मन बहुत सेटिस्फाइड हो जाता है, बहुत खुश होता है फिर?
You mean the achievements made by the industry?
No, about yourself.
Well, in my own career, I would say there are three landmark situations. One was the making of the environment and population. The series called Down to Earth. Then there is the feature film that I did with the Japanese. At least the experience of working with the Japanese production team and contributing it to, with keeping the Indian part of the contribution, the design and the narrative and the music. Now, I was also part of that. And finally, the most important thing that happened in my career was the making of the Meena films, where we promoted the girl child and her situation in India and how it can be improved and what can be done by the family for the girl child. That, I think, has been my major contribution to animation in India.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. Ram Mohan. गुफ्तगू के आज के इस एपिसोड में थे वयोवृद्ध एनिमेशन आर्टिस्ट राम मोहन, जो कि भारत में एनिमेशन कला के जनक लोगों में से एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण व्यक्ति गिने जाते हैं। प्रोग्राम गुफ्तगू के आज के इस एपिसोड के बारे में कुछ कहना चाहते हो तो हमें लिखिए feedback.rstv@gmail.com पर।